Siemaneczko, witam wszystkich bardzo gorąco, ja jestem Bonkol, to jest gra Dead Synchronicity, Tomorrow Comes Today. Moi drodzy, jesteśmy w kolejnym odcinku, niesamowite emocje w poprzednim, jeżeli ktoś nie widział, musi nadrobić. Jesteśmy teraz w takiej piwnicy jakiejś i tutaj zobaczyliśmy, że urzęduje Chris. Chris nam strasznie dużo rzeczy opowiedział i teraz generalnie wychodzi na to, że musimy się udać do kanałów. Mamy latarkę i mapę kanałów, to czego nam brakowało.
While I can't remember her clearly, looking at this photograph gives me a pleasant sense of tranquility. I'm sure Sarah and I were very good friends before the world collapsed.
Dobra. Mamy tą Sarę, musimy ją znaleźć. Tutaj jest biurko Chrisa.
Open books and dirty coffee mugs. I get the impression that Chris lives, works, eats and sleeps at this enormous desk.
Super, stary fotel.
I'm completely exhausted. I feel like I've been wandering around this new world for centuries, but I can't stop to rest now. Not until Chris and I have uncovered the secrets in that army report.
No, mamy jakiś raport wojskowy znaleźć, to wiadomo, że to się z kanałami wiąże. Stary fotel,
dozens of
notatki
and newspaper clippings about conspiracies, attacks, inexplicable occurrences. Looking at the topics of all this material, I can imagine what the editorial line of the new truth is.
I to jest super. Teraz musimy na przykład tak, tutaj spojrzeć na regały. Kufer jest zamknięty, a czekajcie.
It belongs to Chris. Although I could open it with this crow, what kind of friend would do that?
No to niestety
the entire
nie
basement
będziemy
is filled with books, albums, file cabinets and photos. You can even find the odd exotic object in all this. Sarah and Chris accumulated enough material to fill a museum of curiosities.
U góry są jakieś przedmioty. Regały. Tutaj mogę wyjść. Tutaj nic na dole nie ma. Nie mogę tego otwierać. Zdjęcia. Biurko. Nic na ziemi raczej nie leży. Przynajmniej ja nic tutaj nie widzę. Stary fotel. Nie będziemy tutaj siadać. Dobra, moi drodzy, musimy wyjść. Czyli stąd. Okej, czyli już wiemy, co to jest za miejsce. Idziemy do tych kanałów. Nie tutaj. Moi drodzy, idziemy do tych kanałów. Musimy tam dojść. Musimy się dowiedzieć, o co chodzi. O co w tej całej sytuacji chodzi. Dobra. Idziemy z tą latarką. Schodzimy na dół. Burza, moi
drodzy. Here goes. I'll use the map Chris gave me as a guide. These tunnels are a real labyrinth. This is the place marked on the map. The place where Sarah and her confidential source were found.
O kurde, wodospad.
This is where that river of filthy water runs. It's funny, despite the nauseating stench it gives off, there's something hypnotic about that viscous green waterfall.
Obiekt w wodzie.
Trying to stay afloat in the stinking sludge of the sewer. From here, it looks like a castaway waving for help. It's of no use. I'm afraid that there's not much I can do for it now.
Może kurde zarzucę sznur.
First, I need a proper hook for this fishing rod. Even so, I don't quite see why I want that shoe.
Dobra, ale jakiś haczyk. To ja czy tutaj haczyka nie wykombinuję z tym. Dobrze.
Dozens of dark tunnels converge in this area. Most of them closed or inaccessible from here. This place must be the true subterranean heart of the city. There's a very
krata wentylacyjna
coming from the depths of the tunnel behind this grate. It's a subway train. I don't get it. If they boarded up the subway stops and shut down the subway service, what the devil are those trains carrying? And where are they going?
Co to są za... Kurde! Co tam się dzieje? Czemu tam metro działa? O, jesteśmy z tej strony teraz.
I've been able to remove some of the waste, but I won't be able to remove the rest of it with my hands. This stuff is too snarled up.
Okay. Może łomem.
All right. Let's see what the devil is so tangled up in here. My God, Sarah!
Co?
A bullet's torn off her jaw, but her face is still recognizable. Poor Chris. How am I gonna break this to him? One bullet hit her in the jaw, and another went through part of her neck. There's no doubt that Sarah bled to death while using the last of her strength, trying to drag herself out of here. A flash drive. It's sticking out of the corpse's clenched fist. Sarah is holding on to it for dear life, even in death.
Mamy USB.
I'll take good care of it. This piece of plastic was the motive for Sarah's murder. That's how little human life is worth in this hellhole.
Musimy stąd iść. Do czego ja mam to podłączyć? Do jakiego komputera? Czekajcie, tu jest jeszcze komputer. Tu był komputer.
Better not.
Aha, czyli nie mogę, to jest monitor. To może temu damy. Gdzie jest nasz ziomeczek? Idziemy do Chrisa. Idziemy do Chrisa. O.
Hello, Chris.
Michael, you're back already? Tell me, did you find Sarah? Did you bring the report she went out to get?
I brought the report. Here it is.
Oh, that's great news. I knew you could do it. Ah, damn it. I should have guessed. I was expecting a paper dossier, not an electronic document. We have a serious problem, Michael.
Bo nie mamy komputera.
What's wrong?
We're not in the old world anymore. And access to electricity is a privilege very few people have nowadays. The good news is that I was able to save my old laptop from the great wave.
Okay.
The bad news is that we don't have anywhere to plug it in.
What can we do?
If we want to find out the secrets in this report, we need electricity. Bring me a generator with enough fuel, and we'll find all the answers we need, Michael. But tell me, please, did you find Sarah?
Może
Why didn't she come back with you? What happened?
Nie martw się, Chris. Znalazłem wiele śladów, które wskazują to, że Sara jest cała i bezpieczna. Prawda jest najlepsza. Czy powiemy, że nie ma się martwić? Nie no. Okłamiemy go. Albo go skłamiemy. Jest moim przyjacielem, powinienem mu prawdę powiedzieć.
Sarah's dead.
God. But what?
It looks like she and your confidential source were ambushed and shot by soldiers in the sewers. I found Sarah's body in one of the grated tunnels near the refugee camp. I took the report out of her hands, but I had to leave her there.
Oh, my poor Sarah. She didn't deserve that. Please, Michael, don't leave her body to rot in the sewers. I beg of you. Do it for me. For Sarah. For Emily.
I'll do what I can, Chris. I promise you.
Now, get me that electric generator.
Dobra, mamy worek czarny, możemy ją wziąć. Dobra, idziemy teraz, mamy czarny worek, także możemy stąd iść.
Before leaving his house, I shoot a furtive glance at Chris. He's gazing at Sarah's photo in silence, completely lost in thought. Maybe I should have lied about what happened to her. Told him that she got away, leaving the report behind. That she's safe and sound, and just waiting for the right moment to come back. But the truth is a poisonous inheritance from the old world. What good does it do to know it, if it snatches away your last hope?
Dobra, moi drodzy. Co my mieliśmy zrobić? Do tych kanałów iść? Dobra, idziemy. No, powiem wam, że historia nie jest jakaś superancka. Ciało Sary. Jeszcze za oknem u mnie burza się rozszalała.
This corpse deserves a decent burial. Not to be put in a dirty, used plastic bag.
Co kurde?
Oh my God, Sarah's remains.
To jak ja go mam? Do czego ja mam wsadzić ten worek? Znaczy to ciało. No jest czarny worek, no to bierzemy ją na ten i ją do trumny. A o co mu chodzi?
Thick bars at the end of the pipe block extreme. One bullet hit her in the...
Kurde. To może ją porobimy. No to raczej tu nic nie zrobimy. Łomem. No niestety nie udało się nam. Czekajcie jeszcze chwilę. A gdyby iść... Aparat. A gdyby tak iść do tego wojskowego... Tak sobie myślę, że można by tu iść. Co to, znowu te krzewy tutaj zarosły? Serio? A nie, mogę tu przejść, dobra. Dobra. To jest ta umieralnia znowu. Czekajcie, zestawy testowe LED. Kurde. Nie wiem, co tu mógłbym zrobić. Wózek woźny. Wózek woźnego tu był. Pielęgniarka Uma. Czy ja mogę z Umą coś porozmawiać?
Hello, Uma.
Kurde, mol. Masakra, tutaj już nic ciekawego nie znajdę. Dobra. Świetlówki.
Ah, I can't look directly into them. These lights are so bright that it seems like day in here. It must take an enormous amount of electricity to maintain this building. That explains the number of barrels out there. That's where the fuel is stored, that they need to run all the compound's generators.
Tu jest główna sala, tu raczej nic nie zrobię.
This door leads to a dingy back room. I can hear the buzz of electricity coming from inside, but I can't figure out anything more without a little more light. Let's see what this room actually is with a little light. I think I hear the buzz of electricity coming from the surface. I only see empty detergent containers and a beat-up old electrical panel hanging on the wall. Everything indicates that this was a maintenance room from a long, long time ago.
No dobra, panel kontrolny.
I've switched off the circuit breaker.
Dobra, jeszcze raz włączymy. No to idziemy teraz do góry. Okej. Okay. Przechodzimy tędy. Czy ja coś oświetliłem? Skład paliwa tu jest. To ja muszę mieć paliwo dlatego. Jak ja tam mam się dostać do składu paliwa? O, mogę tutaj na dole. Co jest? Czemu idę tutaj? O, fuck. I znowu.
On
się znowu wiesza.
A damn nightmare that repeats over and over again.
Dobra. Czekajcie, bo musiałbym. Czy ja mogę tu wyjść? Nie. Aha. Ten łowca chciał, ale nie mam.
Excellent view of the hospital compound and the fuel depot from here. Shame the camera doesn't have any film.
Nie ma filmu. Trzeba by było zdjęcie zrobić tego miejsca, tylko skąd ja mam film wziąć? Tego raczej nie ogarnę, tak? No jeżeli jestem fotografem, a ja nie mam filmu, no to powiedzcie mi, co ja powinienem zrobić. Gdzieś musi być, chyba że w tym mieszkaniu, gdzie byłem. Tutaj. Tutaj. No tu by musiał być gdzieś film.
This melancholy music makes my hair stand on end. I seem to be hearing the sad voice of Emily in every note. Where are you? How can I find you?
Pozytywka. W szafce były ten...
What for? None of these titles. It's like looking into a mirror. No. I'd only rip it if I tried to pull it down without first taking out the screws.
Tylko bym je porwał.
I wouldn't waste too much time on this. Pounding on the screws holding the fabric won't do anything to loosen.
Na pewno tło fotograficzne muszę ogarnąć. Tylko jak ja mam je ogarnąć? Tu nie mam żadnych narzędzi, którymi mógłbym to ogarnąć. Kurde, może worek sobie naciągnę. Belka. Czekajcie, belka jest jakaś. No to dobra, no to belkę. No to nie mam. No to nie mam pojęcia. No to już nic nie ma. To musimy zamknąć. Musimy teraz zobaczyć, czy coś w szafce. No to już w szafce nic nie można znaleźć tak naprawdę. W tym momencie okno.
No doubt, this must have been one of my simplest and most lucrative jobs. I completed it without even leaving the house.
Bardzo kreatywnie. Dobra, no to tak, tu musimy iść stąd. Moi drodzy. Kubły na śmieci, no tam już chyba nic nie ma. Tam już po prostu nic nie ma. Wybita... A, to już robiłem. Okej, spadamy stąd. Chyba, że jeszcze coś na dachu. No tutaj czekajcie, laptop. After the great wave,
this device is a real archaeological, like an ancient coin. It looks like it's in good shape, except for one thing. There's nowhere to plug.
Dobra, a tu, o, tu jeszcze nie sprawdziłem.
What do we have here? As one would expect, there are only old magazines, stacks of paper and outdated printing supplies here. No, wait a minute. It looks like there's also film prints and cameras here.
Mamy.
Perfect. Now I can load the camera. Ah, the tab that closes the film compartment is broken. I can't use it like this. I need something to hold it in place, or else the film will keep falling out. Tie the wire to the camera? I'm afraid I'm going to have to be a bit more subtle if I want to repair this broken tab.
Taśmę bym potrzebował. I don't think doing... Chciałbym jakąś taśmę mieć, kurde. I'm Łomem!
No.
Czym ja to mam naprawić? W środku jest film, ale zawsze zamykający pojemnik z filmem jest zepsuty.
The film would fall out. Damn it! Why does everything have to be so complicated? Oh Lord! But I can't.
Czekajcie, sterta różności, laptop. To jeszcze bym musiał jakąś taśmę znaleźć, albo cokolwiek, nie wiem. Czekajcie. A tu mogę iść?
This home are... Better not.
Opaska jest gumowa. Ale nie mogę tej opaski niestety tego dobić. Beczka. Idziemy, wracamy. Musimy zdjęcie wykonać. Holender. No nic, tutaj taśma już z baru, bo tu była taśma na barze, ale już jej nie ma. Ja już zużyłem. Do czego ja w ogóle tej taśmy zużyłem? No tu ktoś, bo tu oni naprawiali przewód elektryczny. No ale tu już nie ma. Może, a tutaj nie mogę nic zrobić. Tu już nic nie ma w środku. To możemy teraz spadać. Może tu jeszcze. Moment. Dobra, spadamy. Zęba straciłem. Widzę, że ktoś. O! Dobra. To widzę, czat mi tutaj podpowiedział. Bloated psychopath knocked me down with his flashlight. Now I can say I've made my mark in this new world. Wait a minute. And all that blood, there's something white. It's a fragment of one of my teeth. Kurde. Zęba straciliśmy. I teraz to? O matko, nie wierzę. To czat tutaj ogarnia, ale nie chciałbym, żeby spoilerowali. Załadowany aparat. No to, moi drodzy, spadamy. Okej. Lepiej czasami, jak ktoś podpowie, niż się męczyć pół godziny i nie móc znaleźć rozwiązania. Dobrze. Lecimy. Tutaj musimy przejść. Dobra, i teraz tak. Aha, czemu to jest wyłączone?
Okay, here goes. Damn it. It came out too dark and the flash doesn't help. The photo is...
Dobra, potrzebujemy tego, więc jedziemy. Jeszcze raz musimy włączyć generator.
Great. The circuit breaker I activated is tripped. And it's the only one that seems to work. It'll probably only hold for a little while.
Dobra, czyli szybko musimy to zrobić. Szybko na górę. I szybko zdjęcie.
Let's take a look. Perfect.
Dobra. Dobra. Mamy. I mamy zdjęcie z paliwem. To lecimy z tym. Dobra. Teraz idziemy tutaj. Idziemy do naszego kolegi. Do kolegi łowcy. To jest bardzo ważne. Czekajcie. Łowca tutaj był. Dobra, idziemy do łowcy. Dobra. Masz zdjęcie.
I've brought what we agreed. Here's the photograph of the fuel depot. Fantastic, Mike. Let's see what you've got there. This is incredible. Those pigs have been storing thousands of gallons of fuel, and all within our reach. With your ID, all we have to do is go into the compound, say hello, boys, and bring it all back here. You've just made me very, very happy, dude. I knew I wasn't wrong about you. Now you have to hold up your end of the bargain. Yes, of course I will, Mike. You know I'm a man of my word. Besides, these are hard times, and we have to help one another, dude. I'll get Rod and his wife out of their trailer, so you can have a little time alone with the boy. You have my word.
Dobra, on teraz wyciągnie, teraz rodziców.
But remember, you promised that we'd do it my way, quietly and with no violence. I don't want anybody getting hurt. I just need your men to distract his parents on some pretext for long enough for me to slip in there. Okay? Of course, Mike. You have my word that we'll only do what's necessary. Only what's strictly necessary. Give me a few minutes and then go to the trailer. Everything will be fine when you get there.
No to super, będzie akcja teraz.
Can I ask you for something else? Today you've been the bearer of the best possible news, dude. So shoot. I'll see what I can do.
Kurde, znowu będziemy gadać. Pilnie potrzebuję generatora prądu.
Hey, hey, dude, calm down. I think you misinterpreted my offer. Since the great wave, a generator has become worth more than the lives of 100 people in this camp.
Kurde, masakra.
Don't think I couldn't get you one. But the price will be so high that I can't imagine how you'd be able to pay me. I'm sorry, Mike. But I just gave you access to thousands of gallons of fuel. But those barrels aren't walking out of that place on their own. My men and I are going to have to risk our hides by going into the lion's den. I'm sorry, but the matter is closed.
Żołnierze zamordowali moją
przyjaciółkę. I need you to take care of her body. Well, well, well. Murdered in the sewers. And what the hell was your friend doing there? Wait, don't answer. I've heard about that custom among some relatives of the sick. It means she was hiding a dissolved in the sewers. Or am I mistaken? Yes. You're absolutely, totally, and completely wrong. I'm not gonna tell you what she was doing there. About her commitment to learning the truth. to changing things in the shithole left behind by the great wave, where you move around like a fish in water, you'd be incapable of understanding it. You couldn't even imagine making a sacrifice like that. Even I have a hard time imagining it.
It's none of your business.
Listen, Mike, you know what I think of those disease carriers and of the people who hide them. For everyone's sake, they all belong in the hands of the cleanup brigades. But you know what? Your intentions are good, giving your friend a decent burial. You're loyal to your friends, and I like that. Above all, you've got to be faithful. Loyalty is everything in this new world. So consider it done. I'll take care of it, dude.
Her body is in the sewer tunnel that comes out by the entrance to the camp.
Your friend will have a decent resting place. I give you my word. You should be going now. I've got to get the trailer sorted out. Give me a few minutes and then you can go there, okay? Adios, dude.
Adios. Dobra. Możemy iść.
Wait a minute.
Co to za hałas?
Why is everyone fleeing? What's going on? The cleanup brigades are coming.
A, brygady sprzątające.
God damn it! The hunters turn them in. That animal turns Colin and his family in.
Co za chuj.
No, he's not sick. It's a mistake. Don't take him away. It's all a misunderstanding.
It's just a question of minutes before those bastards break into the trailer and take the boy.
Karetka.
No, don't take him! Please!
One of those vehicles of terror the members of the cleanup brigade used to get around. The ambulance's siren is making an infernal noise.
Czekajcie, zapiszemy sobie. Kurde, masakra. Hunter to nas sprzedał, frajer jeden.
The brigade workers are ready to take Colin away. Rod is...
No, don't take him, please!
Jest, ja muszę rozwalić okno.
Okay, I've gotta act fast. The noise the ambulance makes will cover the sound of the glass breaking.
Włazimy. Colin, pudełko ciastek pierw. Rewolwer.
Michael? Michael? Is that you?
Yes, Colin. It's me. But how do you know my name?
Emily told me a lot about you.
Mam źle kamerę, akurat leży tutaj
pode mną.
She gave
me a message. She said it was very important that I give it to you. What's all that noise outside, Michael? Where are my parents?
It's nothing, Colin. Your parents will be back very soon. Don't worry. But it's impossible for you to have spoken to Emily. She's no longer with us.
Yes. Yes, she is. Emily is always with me. When I go down the underground highways, she's there, waiting for me. Emily gave me a message, Michael. She told me it was something very, very important.
Colin, powiedz, co się dzieje na tych podziemnych ścieżkach.
Tell me what happens on those underground highways, Colin.
The highways are very dark, and I don't want to go down there. They're too scary. There's no light, and they're full of ghosts. There are only shadows and voices down there. Everyone seems very sad and angry. And they tell me things I don't want to know. Things I don't even understand. At first, I hid the whole time, so they wouldn't find me. Or I wandered around by myself for hours in the dark. Until I met Emily. Now I'm not so afraid of the underground highways, Michael. Because she's always there.
Mówisz, że Emily się tobą opiekuje.
You say that Emily takes care of you? But how is that possible?
She protects me. She keeps me from feeling scared. Because I used to be really scared. I didn't know what was happening to me. I didn't understand anything. But now with Emily by my side, everything is much better. She tells me that what's happening to me is normal. That I'm just sick. But that the sickness will go away soon. And that the pain will go away for good then. That she also got really scared when she got sick.
Emily told you that she also got sick?
Yes, she told me that she went through this before me. That a while back she got the same sickness I have. She told me that she felt very lonely too. And that the pain was unbearable. But that it finally ended. And that's
chodziło.
Why I shouldn't worry. That the pain and the fear will go away. She's very kind to me, Michael. She's very kind to everybody. isn't she?
Yes, Colin. Yes, she is. Emily contracted
the same disease. Albo miała tą samą chorobę.
It can't be. Emily, a dissolved? Is that why they didn't let me see your body? Is that the reason for all the secrecy surrounding your death? And what is this message you have to give me that's so important?
She told me that she couldn't come back to be with us, that she will be trapped forever on the underground highways, and that the same thing will happen to me very soon. That's why she asked me to tell you that we're connected, Michael. She told me that you'd understand. We're connected, and it's very important for you to remember that.
Connected? What does that mean, Colin?
Emily told me there was a thread that no one can see that joins us to you, and that's why there's still a chance we can be saved, but that only you could do it while there's still time. She told me that if we're connected, there's still some hope for us all. Can you make everything go back to the way it was, Michael? I don't want to be stuck on the underground highways forever. Can you really make everything go back the way it was, Michael?
We're connected? What does that mean? I don't understand anything. This is all crazy.
Michael, help me. It hurts so much. Make it stop.
Nie mogę na to patrzeć.
What's happening?
Make it stop. Please.
Colin.
My God. I have to get out of here. I have to get out of here.
Hey, get out of our way and let us do our job.
No, don't go in there. I beg of you.
My son. My son.
Colin, no. No.
Damn it. I can't breathe. If it's true that there's a way to change all this, I have to find it now. I don't think I can stand it any longer. I don't think anyone can.
Matko i córko. Mogę tu wejść?
I'm not going back into that room.
Nie wrócę
poor
tutaj.
Colin. His fate was sealed long before I woke. Where could Rod and his wife be? Truth is, I'd rather not know the...
Nie możemy już tam wrócić. No ale co teraz się stanie? Mamy rewolwer.
This revolver still has two bullets in the chamber. The ones Rod and his wife were saving for when Colin passed away. It's possible that by taking it, I've saved their lives. Or, on the other hand, condemn them to go on living.
Kurde, może zastrzelę tych dwóch frajerów. Albo łowcę w ogóle zastrzelę. Wezmę wszystkich, pozabijam. Nie, tych przy generatorze. Ja chcę generator. Ja od nich to, kurde, ogarnę. Zapiszę sobie grę. Tutaj. Ręce do góry!
That pair of ruthless animals have it coming. But the hunter made it clear. If you touch a hair on their heads, you're a dead man. No heroics. Although these...
Idę z nim pogadać. Hunter, ty frajerze. Chodź tutaj.
Hey dude, back already? Nice to see you again around here. Your timing is perfect. So tell me, how did things go with the kid?
Ruthless bastard. You called the cleanup brigades.
Hey, calm down, Mike. Tone it down, okay? Of course I called the cleanup brigades. What did you expect? I was curious about your interest in the boy, so I did a little investigating on my own. My informants poked around Rod's trailer a little, and they discovered some things. Enough to find out how great a risk that kid and his disease represented to camp safety. These are hard times, and we have to take care of each other, dude. It's our common responsibility. Besides, you already know what I think of those disease carriers. And the fools who protect them, Mike.
We agreed that we'd do things my way. We agreed that no one would get hurt.
No, dude. You're confused. I promised you I would do only what was strictly necessary to let you talk to the kid alone. And that's what I did. I made sure the soldiers gave you as much time as you needed to do whatever it was you had to do with that boy. Frankly, Mike, I don't understand why you're complaining.
You gotta do what you gotta do. Is that it?
Of course, Mike. You gotta do what you gotta do. And that's something you already know better than anyone. But now, sit down and have a drink with me. We got things to celebrate. Thanks to the photo you brought us, the plan to get our hands on that fuel at the medical center has been finalized. That depot holds more gasoline than we could ever have imagined in our wildest dreams. We're going over there in a few hours. Hey, Michael, today is turning out to be a great day, don't you think? One of the best I can remember.
No, I'm not going to drink a toast with you because I don't have anything to celebrate. You're a despicable animal.
Hey, watch what you're saying, dude.
A pathetic, ignorant bastard. Garbage from the old world you were so happy to see swept away.
Watch out, Mike. I warned you not to disrespect me in my bar, in front of my men. Don't keep tempting fate.
Are you really offended? You're a vile insect with no morals.
O, so chyba dostaniemy
God and the devil look good to you, you say. Open your eyes and look around, you paranoid worm, because you're nothing but a violent, drunken, demented psychopath, just like your father.
Turn off that music.
Oh no.
Turn off that music right now!
Listen, Michael. There's already been too much commotion in the refugee camp, and more trouble is not in my interest. That's the only thing stopping me from tearing you limb from limb right here and now, and stashing your remains in one of those drums out there. But another word, and you're a dead man. Got it? One more word out of you, and I swear that tomorrow morning they'll find your stinking corpse so tangled up in the barbed wire that they'll have to chop you up to get you out of there. And I don't care where you hide or how far you run, because you know I'll find you in the end. Now get out of my sight. Get out of my sight!
If the hunter finds me inside, he won't hesitate to I have no
Czekajcie, coś tam z kablem.
Of climbing back up there.
Nie możemy nic zrobić. Czekajcie. Ona z tym dzieckiem. Ty, ja jej może dam pistolet.
Hello,
ty, dzieje się coś.
Have you come to help us?
Weź ich, pozabijaj wszystkich.
The great wave entitles me to make any kind of moral judgments. But what I do know is that the hunter and his men are a real cancer in this new world, which is the only thing that really counts right now. The girl has a right to defend herself, that bastard said. So someone should give her the chance to do that. It's only fair, right? I can't get you out of here, Rose. I'm sorry. You're the only one that can do it.
Thank you.
As she was picking up the revolver, she gave me a look of determination that I didn't know she had in her. Rose acted so quickly that I barely saw what happened through the crack in the door of her van. Her hand was steady, even when the second man begged for his life, sobbing and groveling on the floor. The bullet went right through his heart. Blood splattered all over her white dress. And then she let the revolver drop and sat down, lost in her own world. And she didn't do or say anything else. Holed up in her tiny, delirious inner landscape. There she had everything she could ever need, safe at last from the new world, which she will probably never return to. I'm afraid those bastards just played their last hand. I can't help but think those guys got what was coming to them, even if that's a thought worthy of the hunter. I'm afraid that I'm not gonna pick up. There's no point in bothering her. Fortunately for her, Rose isn't here anymore.
Rose jest w innym świecie. Weźmiemy ten generator.
No. The water turned the generator into an enormous hunk of scrap metal.
Kurde, nie wierzę.
Why would I take it with me in this condition? What the hell?
What the fuck?
Another one of those repeating images of those damn time loops.
No. Rose. No, don't do it. No!
It's Rose, killing her captors again. But there's something in this one that makes it different. It feels more real and more intense than the other times. The tank doesn't have any leaks, so no water dripped onto it. It's incredible. But the generator is working again. Damn it. It's taking too long to disconnect the cables that connect the generator to the trailer. I won't be able to grab it before the water ruins it.
Czekajcie. Czekajcie, monety. Trzeba jakoś ochronić to, żeby tam nie zrobiła... Trzeba jakoś zrobić, żeby kula nie przebiła tego. Workiem może.
Too late. Covering it now wouldn't do any good.
A, dobra, no to czekajcie. No. Spróbujmy. Time.
No. Why would I want to take it with...
Czekajcie. A jak wywołać ponownie to?
No. The water turned the generator into an enormous hunk of scrap metal. Why would I want to take it with me in this condition?
Jak wywołać znowu ten time warp? O jest, idzie.
No. Rose. No, don't do it. No.
Dobra. I teraz ona mu przestrzeli tu i pójdzie kula, ale woda nie zaleje. Coś się dzieje złego.
Damn it. I wasn't able to save it. I can only cover half the generator with this.
Które tylko połowę generatora zakryłem, a drugą połowę czym? Dobra. Cholera. Cholerka. Czym mam zakryć połowę? No, fucking shit. Jeszcze coś bym potrzebował. Jakiś materiał, tkanina, cokolwiek. W tym mieszkaniu było to tło, ale ja nie wiem, jak ja mam je ściągnąć. Czym ja mam je ściągnąć? Monetami? What the fuck? Plakatem? Plakat średnio. Czekajcie, spróbujmy. Co ja z tymi monetami mam zrobić?
Let's see. The coins fit
perfectly
in the heads of the
screws. A czyli jako śrubokręt, tak?
No trouble loosening them and taking the fabric with me.
No dobra, to jest wszystko okej. Okay. No tam są takie... No, o, no to kurde, to już jest wyjaśniona sprawa, moi drodzy. To już jest wyjaśniona sprawa. Lecimy rozwiązać sprawę. Dobra. Jedziemy. 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 Dobra. Niech się dzieje, wola nieba.
No. The water turned the generator into an enormous hunk of scrap metal. Why would I want to take it with me in this condition?
Teraz się będzie działo. Aha, czekajcie.
Wrap this object up in the...
Dobra. Teraz musi być time wrap. Musimy wywołać go w tym miejscu. Idzie. Dobra. Owijaj.
No. Rose. No, don't do it. No.
Bam. Nice.
Okay. First, I'll unplug the cables that connected to the trailer.
Dobra, mamy generator. Spadamy stąd. Mamy ten generator, spadamy teraz. Wcale nie jest to podejrzane, że jestem cały w krwi. Nie tutaj, nie tutaj. Tutaj.
I brought the generator you need, Chris.
Great, Michael. Uch. I knew you could do it. Give me a few minutes to set up the computer and open the report.
While Chris was getting everything ready, I decided to sit down in one of the armchairs in the office. I was exhausted. My mind had been trying to make sense of the last few hours of my life for what seemed like an eternity. The first hours following my bitter birth in this new world. But how could I judge the new world if I could barely remember the old one? The only thing I was sure of was that we had lost something very valuable along the way. The photograph of our life, overnight, had turned into a dark, blurry, sepia-tinted image. All of civilization had drowned under the great wave, and the only thing left on the beach were its remains. But no, I was fooling myself. I was already lost before the catastrophe. To tell the truth, all the other victims of the great wave had been luckier than me. They still dreamed of returning to their lives. Mine had already been broken a long time ago. Did I really stand a chance of recovering something I'd already lost forever? What type of strength, what type of miracle could ever give me that second chance?
Michael, wake up!
What's happening?
The report, Michael. It's the report. I was going over it while you were sleeping. It's incredible. It's way beyond our expectations. You're gonna think I've gone crazy, but I don't even know where to start.
How about at the beginning?
Okay. It's the dead synchronicity point. The entire universe is changing, and we're going to witness it. We're going to be witnesses. And victims.
Witnesses? Victims? But what the hell are you talking about? What is this dead synchronicity point?
It's hard to explain. You're a photographer, so I'll try this analogy. Imagine a person's life chronicled in photographs. Up to now, and according to the rules that governed our universe, we were all subject to certain very specific temporal rules. Past, present, and future. That's all there was to it. So, the first thing we'd find would be a photo of the person as a newborn, then another on the person's sixth birthday, then another in college, and so on. Then we'd see photos of the person's wedding, children, old age, death. All in logical, linear, chronological order. Since our universe is conceived along a single line that starts in the past, makes a stopover in the present, and then projects into the future. Do you follow me?
Yes, of course I follow you.
Well, imagine now that this entire temporal architecture crumbles, falls apart, dissolves. Imagine that something or someone has altered the foundations of our universe, changing the rules of the game, forever annihilating our idea of time, the concepts of past, present, and future.
I think you just lost me, Chris.
Then let me continue with the metaphor of the photographs. Imagine now that a card dealer takes all these snapshots that sum up the life of this person, shuffles them, and places them in a stack in one spot on the card table. What would we have then? There would no longer be a chronological line, Michael. There would be no past, present, or future. Each of the individual events captured in these photographs, they would all be happening simultaneously, at the exact same point in time. And that point we would call...
the dead synchronicity point.
Exactly. Now our world is abandoning its old physical laws and getting closer to that dead synchronicity point where time no longer exists.
And therefore, all the phenomena and events that happened or will happen in the universe will start to be stacked on top of other ones, like the photographs in the dealer's deck.
That sounds crazy. How credible do you think this report is?
Completely, Michael. The dead synchronicity point is a fact, and the worst thing is that we're approaching it faster and faster. It'll only be a matter of days, at best maybe a few weeks, before the universe enters this new state. Time is ending, in every sense.
And what does all this have to do with us?
Come on, do you still not see it? This change in the architecture of the universe, this nullification of time, is the real origin of the Great Wave, the Dissolved, and the emergence of the New World.
Moi drodzy, ile informacji, więc fala... Więc jaką falę spowodował nadchodzący punkt synchronii
śmierci? So, the Great Wave was caused by this approach to the dead synchronicity point?
Yes, Michael. The Great Wave was the first manifestation of our universe's approach to the dead synchronicity point. That's why the catastrophe struck at the same time all over the planet. It wasn't just a local occurrence. It had global dimensions. It was the first clear and obvious sign that something was going wrong. And it brought chaos and misery to the world, as you've been seeing yourself since you woke up.
Co z tymi wszystkimi mają wspólnego rozpuszczeni?
What the hell do the Dissolved have to do with all this?
According to the report, the Dissolved are still a big mystery. There isn't much information about them or their disease. What we do know is that they are people who are especially sensitive to the dead synchronicity point, and that is what's so tragic about them.
Especially sensitive?
Of course. This transformation, this radical and overwhelming change in the basic structure of the universe, is totally incompatible with human life. We're condemned to die, Michael. Each and every one of us.
That's terrible. How can you be so sure of that?
If you think about it rationally, it's obvious. Our bodies are the product of hundreds of thousands of years of evolution, of a gradual and precarious adaptation to the environment, the universe, and its physical laws. Reaching the dead synchronicity point, the annihilation of time, we'd need another 100,000 years to adapt to such a drastic change. And what do you think will happen to the human race, to each and every one of us, when this process concludes? I'll tell you. Our primary metabolism will go into a state of shock. Our entire cell structure will be jolted so profoundly and so violently that what we now call our bodies will lose all coherence, leaving behind just a brown puddle as evidence of our existence.
We'll dissolve, like those poor sick people.
Indeed. According to the report, the Dissolved are simply pioneers, people who are ahead of their time. The vanguard of the human race in its final extinction. That's why some cases started cropping up so early, even before the Great Wave. Their illness was the harbinger of the enormous explosion that was to follow. It preceded it by hours, even days. And that's why the cases are multiplying exponentially as we get closer to the end. Do you understand? We'll all end up turning into Dissolved.
Podczas naszej poprzedniej rozmowy wspominałeś, że istnieje rozwiązanie.
You told me that there could be a solution, a way to reverse all this madness.
Yes, and that's the best part of the report. Theoretically, Michael, and paradoxical as it may sound, our progress toward the dead synchronicity point also brings the opportunity to change things, to turn the process around and return to where we were before our world collapsed.
So?
And how would that be possible?
By penetrating the very center of the anomaly, the deepest nucleus of dead synchronicity, and arriving at the point where time is just starting to fold back into itself before the process is completed. If, inside the dead synchronicity point, each and every one of the events that have happened or will happen in the universe unfold, then surely it must be possible to gain access to the moment when something or someone triggered the catastrophe and stop it.
I can't believe what I'm hearing. You're talking about time travel.
Yes, I'm talking about the possibility of accessing the past to save our present and our future. Of turning the Great Wave and all its consequences into a mere nightmare that never actually happened. The report talks about the hypothetical existence of a door leading into the very heart of the dead synchronicity point. A door to each and every one of the snapshots of the past, present, and future of our universe. And if, through that door, we had a chance to access the precise instant when everything went haywire, then we might be able to change things. Michael, that's what we've got to focus on in whatever time we have left. But I have to continue studying this report. I'm sure there are more answers in it, and you have got to help me.
You're telling me that the dead synchronicity point is the origin of all this chaos? That our only chance of salvation is a theoretical journey to the past? Or sooner or later we'll all be obliterated, like those poor dissolved?
That's right, Michael. So we'd better get to work on it as soon as possible. By the way, the report also mentions another very interesting thing about the dissolved.
What is it?
It seems that in their trances, through their trips to the underground highways, the sick form a strange relationship with each other. It's as if the disease unites them, regardless of any physical distance that might separate them. The report is very unclear on this point, but it seems as if the dissolved are somehow linked, connected.
My God. That can't be.
Remember. Please, remember.
Everything fits now. Everything makes sense.
Please. Enough! My head!
Emily asked me to tell you that we're connected, Michael. We're connected!
Michael, what's going on?
Chris, get one of those tests ready. Fast.
But what for? You don't think that you're also...
Do as I say.
Okay. Give me your hand.
Chyba jesteśmy też rozpuszczeni.
It's positive. Michael, you're sick. You're dissolved.
No. That can't be. No! No!
Michael? Michael? Wake up!
Emily? Emily, is that you?
Please, Michael, wake up. Wake up!
Is that really you? Where am I?
Yes, Michael.
Starzeje się.
You are on the underground highways.
I tyle. Kurczę. Dobra gra, moi drodzy. To była dobra gra. Oczywiście bardzo poronione pomysły były tam wykorzystane. Podróże w czasie i tak dalej. Wiadomo, wiele rzeczy nierealistycznych, ale to jest gra oczywiście. Bardzo mi się podobała, moi drodzy. Nie, to jest spoko. Takie zakończenia są spoko, bo można sobie myśleć teraz, czy mu się to wydawało, czy on był faktycznie chory i wiele rzeczy mu się przydarzyło takich, co się przydarzyło właśnie osobom rozpuszczonym. Takie zakończenia są najlepsze, bo jak macie podane na tacy, to nie skłaniają do żadnego namysłu. Moi drodzy, dobra, ja wam dziękuję bardzo. Jeszcze raz powtarzam, to była gra kupiona w Biedrze, 19 zł, najlepiej wydane chyba przez nie wiem od kiedy. Bardzo dobra gra, jeżeli wam się podobało, dajcie łapkę w górę. I tyle. Trzymajcie się. Dziękuję wam bardzo za oglądanie. No chyba, że jeszcze coś jest na końcu. Poczekałbym do napisów, ale... Chyba, że już jest koniec. Kurczę, ale to było dobre. Mówiłem na początku, że to jest polska produkcja, nie ma tu polskiego nazwiska. Nie, to nie jest bezpośrednio polska, ona miała tylko... to był mój błąd. Powiedziałem, że to jest polska gra. Natomiast błędnie odczytałem pewne informacje na stronie. Ona tylko miała polskiego wydawcę, natomiast nie była robiona przez polskie studio. Także... Czekam jeszcze. Czekam, bo może coś wyskoczy. John Kirby, moi drodzy, William Andrews. No ciekawe to było, bo ja tak się domyślałem, to znaczy mi się nie podobało w tej grze kilka rzeczy, to powiem teraz. Nie podobało mi się to, że niektóre fakty były zbyt oczywiste, znaczy niektóre rzeczy, które się nam przydarzały, były zbyt oczywiste i tak samo to, że on już się dowiedział, że osoby chore mogą się kontaktować tak jakby z innym światem. I to, że my po prostu mieliśmy te takie time wrapy, czy jak to tam się nazywa, czyli generalnie podróżowaliśmy niby w czasie, widzieliśmy ten świat trochę z innego, z tego innego punktu, jak to było kiedyś, czy jak to będzie wyglądało, no to już dało nam do myślenia, że on faktycznie jest chory, nie? Tak samo te głosy, które on gdzieś tam słyszał, ale... W każdym razie, no, moi drodzy, gra była super. Jak widzicie, gra była też prawdopodobnie stworzona gdzieś na jakimś crowdfundingowym serwisie, może jakimś Kickstarterze. Także tutaj są wszystkie osoby wypisane, jak widzicie, wszystkie osoby wypisane, które tam pewnie wpłaciły jakiś hajsik. To też jest pewnego rodzaju zaleta, bo patrzcie ile nazwisk, patrzcie, a to dopiero jest A. Także... Bardzo dużo osób, moi drodzy, tutaj będzie pewnie wymienionych. No i mi się to podoba. Takie gry niech tworzą, to jest wszystko piękne. Dobra. Moi drodzy, dziękuję wam bardzo serdecznie za oglądanie. Tutaj już chyba nic szczególnego się nie wydarzy. Ja wam dziękuję, do zobaczenia. Kończę ten materiał. Cześć.